In this video, we are going to learn how to create amazing video titles like this. It can be shapes as well, and even icons with differential videos. So let's get started step by step. We need some text. We need a video, and if required, another background. Let's start with the text. When you type text, you should choose a font which is having thick stroke. So any type of font which has black or extra bold are good candidates. Make the font size large so that the video, when it is shown through the font, has enough space to reveal itself. Make sure you have selected a text box like this. One common mistake here is we go and type text here. Do not use these. These are called placeholders. So you delete all the existing placeholders, go to shape, new text box, and type what you want. I've already done that. Now select the text box. You will see shape format. A couple of things we need to do here. We are going to need this button, which is the real crux of this whole video titling thing. We are going to need this powerful button. I want this button to be always available to me. So right click on this button, merge shapes, and click to and add to quick access toolbar. Similarly, at some point we may need editing of points. Again, right click, add to quick access toolbar. Notice these buttons are currently inactive. That's okay. When we need them, they will be active. One more thing we need is selection pane. So right click, add to quick access toolbar. Now we are going to use selection pane first. Selection pane is this. It gives me a list of all objects. I have the video on a separate slide. I'm going to copy the video and put it on the same slide as the text. In order to send it to back, yes, I can use right click send to back, but this is much simpler from selection pane, drag drop. Whenever you are working on this, there is some amount of trial and error. You may make a mistake. You don't want to undo so many times. I'm going to duplicate this slide. Now we'll work on one of the copies. Next step, select the video. Press the control key and click on the text box. Both are selected. The order of selection matters. First video, then the text box. Then we go to the merge shapes button. Open this. There are many amazing options there. Union is not going to work here. What has combined done? It has removed the font. The video is still a video. Fragment creates pieces. We don't want that. What we want is intersect. It is still a video. It is a single video. You can see that this video is 14 seconds long. On the selection pane, we see one object. This is a video. How do I know it's a video? I can see video format and playback. It's called a picture. That's just an anomaly. To avoid confusion, just double click there, call it video. This video is not going to run on its own. So you go to the playback tab and say start automatic. I also want to loop this video because I may show the slide for longer than 14 seconds. And now this is how your title will look. Already it's amazing, and of course you can enhance it further. Right now you are consciously looking at when the video is ending. Now I'm going to remove this, and now the video will end and start. You will not even notice when that happened. That's because the videos were picked up from Microsoft video stock images, which are loopable videos by default. There's one video. I want to split this video into two videos. How do we go about doing it? Made some copies. Work on a copy. I'm going to go to shapes and draw a freeform shape. And now I'm going to complete the shape like this. So part of the video is overlapped by the shape. This one also I'm going to make copies. I want to split the video into the lower part and the upper part. Let's do the lower part first. Select the video, control and click the shape, merge shapes and say subtract. That will keep the part which was not overlapping. Now go to the duplicate slide, select the same objects in the same order, but this time we are going to say intersect. So only the common portion is going to be kept. Now I copy this, put it on top of this. Now it looks as though it is same, but the videos are not going to run together because the animation is gone. So select both the videos, go to playback, go to clicked on automatically, and loop. But there's one more extra step because the first video will start running immediately. The second video by default gets the animation start after previous. You want to change that to start with previous. And now they will run as expected. But then what's the point in making two pieces? So let's separate the pieces out. And then I want to apply animation in such a way that it comes together after the videos start running. To do that, I need to add an animation. So go to animation. Don't add from here. This is add animation. This is replace animation. I want to add a motion path. This is the point I want to move in such a way that it just overlaps here. This is the animation applied movement. I want the movement to happen with the previous, but with a delay. So I'm going to move this a little after 1.5 seconds. Now when I run it, look at the impact. After 1.5 seconds, they will merge beautifully. So this is how, once you get the concept right, you can just play with it and do exactly what you want. The next step is to see how to crop video to any shape. I have a simple star shape here, and I have the video, which is a starry sky, which looks like this. Notice that the hill portion is not moving. The sky is moving. The concept is similar. So I'm going to make copies of these and copy the star, put it on top of the video. Make sure the overlap is right because the hill is not moving. So I'm going to arrange the shape in such a way that it overlaps the moving part of the video. And now you already know what to do. Go to the video, select the star as the second one, and then choose intersect, playback, automatic, loop. And there you have it. This is great. But suppose I want three stars of three different shapes and I want to rotate them. No problem. Concept is similar with one extra tweak. So instead of one star, I want three stars. That's not a problem. I can choose different shapes or just make three copies of these. Now the problem is if I copy these and paste it on top of this video, I'll have to do subtract so many times. That's not going to work. So before I do any subtract or intersect, I want these to be single as a shape. The same button helps you here. I have just selected the shapes and now I say union. It actually creates one shape. It's absolutely amazing. Now the steps are same. Select video, control click shape, and then intersect. This is one video, not three videos. So same process again. This is still a shape from PowerPoint point of view. Although it says video, it's still a shape. So if you go to video format and click on this button, this is format shape. Although it is video, it's still having all the format shape options. What does that mean? I can put 3D format here. So I'm going to make it look 3D. And I'm going to use 3D rotation as well. Like this. And because they are rotated now, I can see their depth. So I'm going to come to 3D format and depth part, I'm going to increase. And just to make it even more interesting, I'm going to choose a different background so that it stands out. And when you run it now, this is the impact you get. We can apply the same principle to any icon. We have a large collection of icons in insert and icons. Icon typically is not just one simple shape. It's something more illustrative. I've already selected one icon. What I really want to do in this icon is the cloud portion should have a video of clouds. And the sun portion should have a completely different video, something bright and sparkly. Let me get both the videos first. I copy the cloud video, put it in the same slide, go to selection pane, move it behind. That's okay. Now the icon is much smaller, so I can reduce the size of the video so that it only handles the cloud portion. The steps are same. Select the video, control click. But this time, when I try to do any of these operations, they don't seem to have the desired impact. For example, intersect is not working at all. Why is that? Because this is not a shape. It's a graphic, say SVG graphic. So first we have to convert it to shapes. How do you do that? Right click, group, ungroup. You can also use the shortcut Shift Control G or Shift Command G. It warns you that this is a picture, not a group. Doesn't matter. Click yes. Nothing seems to happen. Ungroup again. And now we got individual pieces and suddenly we have too many shapes here. We will find out which is the shape which belongs to the cloud. That happens to be this one. To avoid confusion, I'm renaming it as cloud. Select the video, control click cloud, and intersect as before. And there we have it. Now the same thing I want to do with the sun, but let's select all first, unselect this one, so all the sun components are selected. Before we do anything else, let's create a union. So now it's a single shape. Let's take the sparkly video, put it on top of this, send it to back, make the size smaller so that it should just cover the desired portion. Select the freeform shape, which is a combination of all components of sun, and the same process, intersect. Automatically, no clicks required, loop until stop, go to animation pane, make sure the second one starts with previous. And before we do anything else, let's also make this 3D and make the background a little more contrasting and put a shadow. When I finished doing all this, I thought, oh, this sun can be represented better by this video. Now what do I do? Well, exactly the same process. Copy the video, paste it, put it behind everyone, select the video, select the sun, and subtract. Reset the animation, and it's done. I'm sure you found this useful, so share it with as many people as you can. Like it, put some comments, ask me questions, tell me if I missed something, and that way, YouTube also understands that this is good, and then it's going to share it with many more people, and that's how you and me together can make the world a more efficient place. So that's it for now. Thank you.